Okay, I think we're live. I'm really, really excited to see everybody. How is everybody today? So my friend and colleague Anne is joining us today from Handle Your Backend. She's going to tell us all sorts of amazing, give us all sorts of amazing advice around money. We're going to be talking about finding more time and money today. Anne, why don't you introduce yourself?
Sure. You gave a good start. My name is Anne Tipton. I'm the owner of Handle Your Backend. So what we do there is help business owners get their financial, legal, and wealth building stuff handled so they can get back to running their business.
Yeah. Anne is really, really amazing. We met, what is it, like, not a year ago, maybe like...
No, it was over a year ago.
What? No, don't say that. But so we met back at an event in Stamford, Connecticut for our businesses, and we hit it off immediately. She treated me to the best. So if you want treated to good breakfast, she treated me to the best breakfast I think I've ever eaten. And she is a wealth of knowledge about money and finances and all of that.
So, that was very funny. I like that very much.
as we can talk about this, I think I've told some of you guys, and if you don't know me, I am Carly Myers. I am the founder of Adhesive Positivity Studios. I always forget to introduce myself. And what I do is I help people use creativity to get their mojo back, to basically make adulting fun. But so it's really funny that that is how Anne and I met, because one of the things that I end up feeling money guilt about a lot is food. I love to eat out. I love to, like, if I'm going to splurge, like if I'm having a bad day, like I'm going to go to the grocery store or like the pizza place down the street and I'm just going to like buy it all. It's going to all be mine. And so it's really funny that we met over food, because that is definitely something for me. But, I wanted to talk about this idea of money guilt, especially with my free online training that's coming up next week, next Tuesday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so I hope you can join, is this idea of creating more time and money. But we really can't create more time and money if, especially the money part we're talking about right now, if we have and hold on to this money guilt. So it's kind of like this, and feel free to chime in whenever. This idea that when we spend money, if we like are spending it with a specific emotion, we're basically going to receive that back. So if I'm spending, if I'm buying food with a sense of guilt, I'm just going to get that sense of guilt as I'm eating it. Like basically is what's happening. Do you have thoughts on that, Anne?
Yeah, that sucks. I mean, it's so true that's how things work. And I actually wrote a book. It's a little ebook that we're going to give a link out to later that kind of addresses some of those issues, because it doesn't feel good to treat yourself and then have the treat not feel like a treat anymore. Because who wants to go splurge on ice cream or pizza and then feel guilty the whole time you're eating it? That's not the point. And Carly, I do think it's perfect that you and I like bonded over food, because we're obviously such food people. I think that's
exactly.
Ideal. Food is very important. And so is drink in my world. And that's why the book that we're giving away is called The Champagne Test, because I take this food and drink thing very seriously.
And you guys, I did put a link to her champagne test in the description, so you should definitely check that out. But that's really funny. And a lot of the people that have been following me on Facebook Live and for a while, and I'm sure you've seen some of my crazy videos, have heard me complaining that I recently started being gluten-free and dairy-free due to a health issue. And so I have been complaining nonstop about all of not being able to like treat yourself. believe me, I have found some ways. But I know you have a lot of clients that you work with, and you're really helping them work through this like idea of money guilt. So maybe you could tell us a story that maybe some of my followers or viewers could relate to and connect with you in that way.
Sure. So I'll share a personal story, actually. So one of the main purpose of the champagne test is to spend money and feel good about it every time you spend money. So you don't have that guilt. You don't have that shame. You don't have that like icky. And so a personal story about this is kind of about testing if what you really want is what you really want. For a long time, I had this idea that I wanted a convertible. Now, in Indiana, this is not a very practical thing to want, okay? We got about maybe 3 months that you can drive that sort of thing around. And, you know, just not a very practical thing. But, you know, the 16-year-old inside of me wanted a convertible, you know, the hair blowing in the wind and the whole thing. So I was on vacation with a girlfriend, and we were in Florida and, you know, bebopping around, and we stopped at the airport and got our rental car. And they said, you know, for an extra $20 a day or whatever, we could get the convertible. And I was like, heck yes, we want a convertible. Like, I mean, for $20 more a day divided by two people, like, no brainer. This was absolutely happening. Well, Carly, it turns out that I hate riding in a convertible. So, but you don't know that until you have the experience. So sometimes it really is just about, you know, I could have gone my entire life, you know, hit my mid to late 40s and had a midlife crisis and bought a convertible that I didn't really want. And I wouldn't have known that if I hadn't just let myself play in that realm a little bit. So sometimes testing what you want can be really advantageous, because then you don't have to carry around for 30 years this guilt of like, ah, oh, this thing that I want and I can't have.
Right. So what do you say about people who that you work with that are dealing with things like student loans? I know we did actually a collaboration a couple months ago on that. Like, what about that type of money guilt? I usually tell my clients that, you know, that's basically a loan, like an investment in yourself, and it's not something to feel guilty about. But what do you, like, what are, do you have techniques or suggestions for overcoming something like that, where it's really kind of feels like it's bogging us down and keeping us from moving forward in our lives?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think the biggest thing, because especially with something like student loans, if you've got a great big amount, or like a mortgage, which is obviously going to be a pretty huge sum that you're not going to just pay off, you know, next week, more than likely. The thing that I tell my clients is to just get really intentional about what it is that you want. So how do you figure out, you know, the balance between, okay, I've got to make my mortgage payment, I've got to make my student loan payment, and I want to eat out. So it all involves really just coming up with a really clear plan. And that's part of what the champagne test will walk you through, is getting really clear about what you want and how you can get it. And there are some creative ways, kind of like the convertible story, about, you know, testing the water, seeing if what you want is really what you want. So you don't have to feel bogged down and guilty. And sometimes just dipping your toe in the water feels really good, instead of, you know, diving all the way in the deep end.
Yeah, and that's really interesting, is that whole idea of dipping your toe in the water. Because I think I've been talking a lot this week about listening to your heart and letting your ego do its thing. And one of the things that I've done for myself in the last year or two is start to travel, which I would have never met you, Anne, if I hadn't have dipped my toes in the water, right? I know that would have been horrific and terrifying. But so what I did was, instead of saying like, oh, I'm going to go to Germany, like I'm dying to go to Germany, and it is in the financial plan, I'm like, okay, you know what, I'm going to go to Stanford. I'm going to take a train ride there, and I'm going to get a taste of like, okay, what is this city like? What is this town like? What are the people like? Get a taste of like the thing that my heart really wants. And so that even helps you kind of feel less bogged down by everything, and you feel like excited. I mean, right, I'm telling you, and dipping the toe in the water will lead you to things too. It's just a matter of like drowning versus toe dipping.
And we don't need to drown the first trip. Like let's
toe drown.
Yeah.
So, Anne, what do you think about that? Do you have thoughts on like toe dipping techniques? Like, what, maybe there's a story that you have, or?
So what I'll do is start to go a little bit into what the champagne test covers, because I think this is a good place to walk into that a little bit. So the champagne test is one of the three things that you're going to walk through as you walk through the little ebook. Is do you want beer, wine, or champagne? So when you're looking at making a purchase, any purchase, whether it's a handbag or a meal out, you know, sometimes you really do want the champagne. You want to go to Germany. You want, you know, the nicest bottle of whatever on the menu. You really want the high-end thing. But like you say, a lot of times just a good cold refreshing beer will do it. Like give me, you know, on a hot summer day, that cool, refreshing, bubbly, like that's fine. That's enough. And so sometimes a trip to Stanford, you know, which is the beer option, like it's a train ride and a couple of nights in a hotel. And I mean, a girlfriend and I split the cost of the room, right? So like, it doesn't even have to be a lot of money. And sometimes that beer will satisfy that itch, that urge to go travel or to have a new handbag or to, you know, whatever it is that does it for you. Sometimes beer is good enough. And sometimes you want the middle option, right? Sometimes it's all about the wine. So beer, wine, or champagne, that's how we got to the champagne test. That's where the title comes from. So yeah, I think that's a really good way to maybe start with beer and work your way up to champagne.
Yeah, it's so interesting. And I think really it's what's funny is that my choice, and I'm like, I want to do the finger thing too. my choice in doing kind of the beer and going to Stanford led me to, like a little history about me and my business, guys, if you don't know it, is it led me to sign up for a business coaching program, which led me to build my business. I met Anne in the process. We've collaborated together. And in building my business, I ended up, you guys saw probably like 2 or 3 weeks ago, I ended up winning a trip to go to LA. So I take an hour plane or an hour train ride that leads me to flying across the country. Like, that little dip, that little faith and letting go of the money guilt around just dipping your toes in the water to begin with will lead you to the things that you want. And for me, it's all about mindset. And I know that for Anne, it really is, we've talked about that too, and letting go of like this idea of like letting go of whatever mistakes you have had in the past, whatever, you know, with money or relationship that you feel badly about. I actually recently did this really great exercise where I wrote all of my debts. This was like a couple months ago, all of my debt and like where it came from. And I think, Anne, we might've done something similar together.
Yep.
It was on magician paper. Is that what it's called? And so I wrote on it, and you light it on fire and drop it. And before it hits the ground, it completely disappears. So it's like burning and then it just disappears. And it was doing something like that, where maybe like writing all of your debt on a post-it note or like whatever you feel guilty about, and just like burning it. Now, don't catch your house on fire or anything. Not a good idea, but letting it go, that would be a really good exercise to do to be able to move forward and grasp that money mindset that is abundant and, you know, not bogged down by something.
Well, and I think it's, your story is perfect because you started with your beer option, right? And you let that guilt go. You did it anyways, even though you have student loans, like you went ahead, you made the commitment, to, you know, to God, the universe, whatever you believe in. And you were able to get to champagne for free with your trip to LA, right? Like that may or may not have been a feasible thing for you to do financially, but that's a big leap from a train ride to Stanford. Like that's huge.
Yeah.
So it's amazing when you set those wheels in motion and you get that continuity moving along, it's amazing what happens.
Yeah. And I'm always saying like this like skydiving analogy, I'm sure everyone uses it these days, but the most scary part about skydiving, about like following your heart and doing, you know, what you want to do is the moment you're in the plane and you're at the door and you're totally safe. Like you are absolutely 100% safe in that moment. But you are so scared. And that's what I think is what is happening kind of with money guilt. We're in the plane, we're safe, but we're scared shitless. But all we want to do is jump out, right? All we want to do is experience that free fall and that the abundance that the universe, God, whatever, can support you with. And also financial help people can support us with. and then we feel really, really good and really exuberant and really excited, and we end up letting go of that guilt and feeling that core desired feeling, whatever that is for you. So I think that's a really good kind of analogy for letting go. Like we are, when we're in money guilt, when we're holding on to that past, to the student loan debt or to the mortgage or to like, I don't, what if I go on this trip and you know, I can't afford it or whatever it is. When we're holding on to that, we're not serving ourselves. So yeah, I think, maybe for somebody, some of the people that just came in, talk about your champagne test again, or your champagne test, because I think that's really powerful, and I think it's a really good way to make the first step in letting go of all of that.
Yeah, it's a free download, so I mean, there's no commitment really, other than your email address. We'll send you a copy right over, and it's basically how to not feel guilty around purchases that you make. A lot of times in life, you know, we buy things to feel good, and then we have that shame and that guilt that allows us not to enjoy it anymore. And that sucks. So let's just get rid of that. So yeah. That's in a nutshell what the book is. It's super easy. And Carly, I know you're promoting something as well. You want to talk a little bit about that?
Of course. You guys have probably heard me talk about it a million times, but I'm so excited that I am going to be doing a free online training next Tuesday, June 13th at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And it is called 3 Ways to Find More Time and Money for the Things That Matter. So it's all about, you know, finding ways to make room for the things that you want in your life. And what you can do, there's actually only 24 spots left. So make sure you, I posted the link in the description to this live video. So make sure you grab your spot. It's how many days away? 5 or 6 days away. So it's not too long. We're running out. I'm really, really excited about it. And I hope to see you there. And I really, really thank you, Anne, for joining me tonight. It was so much fun. I love catching up. We'll have to do this actually over food next time. And yeah, it was really great. And I think we'll wrap it up. Any final thoughts or words for the group, Anne?
Awesome. No, just the more you can do to let go of that guilt, the better life is. So just let it go.
All right. See you guys later.